Hey guys, so we're back on the road again, or will be very shortly. I was just stopping to get a cold beverage, some kombucha, and keep me company. It's about a 20-minute drive out to Kingsport Beach. I've got some friends who are heading out there and said, hey, you should come and meet us. And I haven't been up there in a while, and it's a really neat little spot. And we drive through Canning first, and I might stop in there and check out some of the stores. There's an art store and an ice cream shop, and I think that might make for a fun little bit of video documentarianism. Yes. Anyway, I have a cold drink, so I'm ready to go. Farmland up ahead here used to be underwater. That's what the dikes hold back. Look at this. There's some farming coming past us there. So if you're a farmer and you need some heavy-duty equipment, that's the place you go to buy a new great big toy. Oh, I think that must be really cool. I would imagine it's lots of fun to buy a new tractor, especially a shiny blue one like they had back there. Because when I was a little kid, tractors and dump trucks and stuff like that were all the rage in all the sandboxes in my childhood. Here we are rolling into lovely Canning, a town on the other side of the dikes. This is where you get into the foothills of the other side of the dikes, I guess. And it's a neat little town. I know a couple of people who live out this way. It's a bit of a haul in the wintertime. If you work in, you know, in Wolfville or New Minas, then you gotta take a big long drive across the blustery plains between you and it. In the winter, it can be. It's like crossing the Arctic or something. But in the summertime, it's so pretty. I think I'm going to stop. I saw a sign for ice cream, and there's a neat little shop along here I want to check out. I hope they're open. I hope that my car is still here when I return. It doesn't say no parking. Maybe that's just town color. Maybe it's a joke. We'll see. Anyway, let's go wandering around this town. Are they open? Oh, they're open. This is exciting. Cash only. I think I have cash only. Let's find out.
Let's get out of the way. See you later. Thank you.
Hello.
Well, hello. How are you?
I'm doing very, very well. Is this your shop?
It is.
Oh boy. I've been hoping to come back here, and I was like, I hope she's open. I really want ice cream, and Can you tell me a little bit about your shop?
Sure. Ice cream. I've been around since 2016.
Okay.
And basically, I'm ice cream only right now. Things have changed a little bit in our world.
When I go into an ice cream place, I'm only thinking about ice cream. So I don't think you're necessarily on the wrong track with that.
Right. Well, if you're not into the hard stuff today, I also have soft ice cream. It's real ice cream, not soft serve. And that can be.
What do I do, soft or hard? I have to go hard just because there's a coffee flavored one there, and that's where my heart lives. So how's business been?
It's been really good. I'm surprised how many people from Halifax and Dartmouth
really
came here.
That's great.
It is.
Week. I've had more in the last week than I've had in years before.
I think people are so compressed. They're just like, okay, we're gonna go to the beach. We're gonna get ice cream. We're gonna do
it
all.
It feels normal to get out.
Oh my goodness.
Yes, and it's traveling within their own province, which is awesome.
Yes.
More people need to do that because where we live, there's different beauty everywhere.
I was hoping to, I'm going to put my camera here. And
okay.
Hey, I brought cash. I'm so smart.
Sweet.
Or so
smart
lucky.
You.
How much is that?
$4 even, please.
I knew to bring cash from last year. I made sure I had it.
And one more change. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. All right, thank
Enjoy
you. What was your name again?
June.
June, if you want to come out to Canning, visit June's restaurant, or what do we call this? An ice creamery.
A little ice cream shop. It's called I Scream.
I Scream. screen. There we go. And I'll reproduce that information at the bottom.
Awesome.
All right.
Here's my info.
Oh, right on. That's perfect.
Beautiful.
Now I have too many objects. Okay.
I'll get your door for you.
Thank you so much. All right.
Thank you.
For me. Well, that was positive. And there's a bunch of cool things in this town. There's also an art shop, and I don't think I'm going to go in there right now. Oh, are they open? Hello, hey, how are you? I just wanted to come in and say hi, because
yeah,
it's been a million years.
Yeah.
Oh, it's been, I
you really do have your hands.
I really do. I got ice cream, which is melting rather quickly. I'll have to, you know.
Yeah.
Do you have a cup or a holder of some kind? You don't.
I'm a pot. Here's actually one that hasn't been touched in a while.
So. Ooh, that's perfect. Okay, yeah. Let's put that in there and hope that it doesn't. It's perfect. So, can you tell me a little bit about the operation you have running here?
Well, it's a pottery. Let me turn their radio down.
Okay, sure. There we go.
Yeah, so this is my pottery studio, Aspinall Pottery and Canning.
Oh, introduce yourself, please.
Yes, my name is Denise Aspinall, and so we're in the Aspinall Pottery Studio, and I do all the work here on the potter's wheel or by hand, and I sell from here.
I owe you some money. I bought something like a long time ago, and I kept it. I'll pay you. It was like $25 or something like
sure?
that. Maybe.
I thought we'd settled that.
Maybe we had. I get older, and maybe if you just don't remind me, I'll just keep you in cash for the rest of your life. That'd be nice.
Yeah.
But anyway, if you could maybe just give me a little tour.
So, it's not a big space. Sort of what you see is what you see. This is the retail little section there. So all these pieces are for sale. Hopefully, coming tourists at some point.
Well, the ice cream shop sounded like they were doing booming business. People are getting out. They're like, okay, we're free. We can look around. And so I think maybe
there's a bit of a frenzy right now for people to get out.
To relax, hurry up. You know, I love the stuff that comes out of this shop. It's the designs all sort of sit within the same aesthetic kind of vibration,
exactly.
I guess.
Exactly. It's been 40 years now.
You've been doing this for 40 years.
Mm-hmm. I have.
Oh my God!
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So there's a few people around collecting it now. So.
Oh, you do. So do you have like lists of names that you'll email? Hey, I have a new run of cool things. Maybe be interested.
I used to do some of that. Now I just sort of depend on them coming to me when they need me, and I've been at the market, as you know, for years.
Yes. Do you take bank machine cards?
I do.
Thank goodness, because I want to buy something.
Right on. Free thing here.
I would like to buy another coffee mug because I love the other one.
Tons of mugs.
Oh, wow. Okay, folks, this is really exciting. Let's see. So the last one I got was in this sort of shape.
In the browns.
It was beautiful. I love it. But I want a bigger, wider one, and you have a few of those. Maybe I'll get another brown one. That one's lovely. How much
that
is this?
That looks like you.
That looks like me.
Let me wrap that up.
Sure. Okay. How much is that before I commit?
$35.
Perfect. That sounds like a very reasonable thing. So do you have anything, cooling right? Like, what's your current
stuff? You can come back here and look at the kiln. This is the pottery kiln, so I'm loading it up now with pieces for a first firing. They have to go through two firings, so what they look like.
Why do they have to go through two firings?
Well, these are fragile right now, so if I picked it up by the edge, it would just snap. So they have to be hardened, and they have the decoration on, but this turns to the blues and greens, so it's a bit deceiving. And then they get dipped in glaze and fired again.
Oh, that's where they're shiny. Okay.
Yeah. So
I always found glaze interesting because you'd paint it on. I said, no, really, that's not mud brown. It's going to be blue.
Exactly.
Or green or whatever. Which colors will these be when they're ready?
So these are actually going to be all blue, these ones.
That.
And then the little bit of white stuff that you see will be kind of the berries that are typical of my design.
Well, that's exciting. How long is a firing?
The first firing is about 9 hours. And then it has to grow up gradually, otherwise the pots will explode.
Right, you got to do it a bit at a time.
And the second firing is quicker. The glaze firing is about 6 hours.
I remember when we were doing some pottery back when I was like, I don't know, 10. there was like a summer studio kind of thing. I went to that and they told us, yeah, little air bubbles, they can explode. And I was like, really?
Yep.
Huh.
Yep.
So me and a couple of the boys really made little air bubbly round things and stuffed them up on purpose to see if they blew up. And like they didn't. We were so disappointed.
Oh.
But well, I was a real shit when I was a kid. Whiz.
I can't believe it.
No. And this is your clay, it looks like. Yeah. You get orders of big boxes of mud.
Yeah, I get about 40 boxes of that at a time. So
where does that come from?
This clay comes from Tucker's in Richmond Hill, Ontario.
I guess they have good mud in Ontario.
Well, they make all sorts of different clays for different purposes, like porcelains and stonewares and earthenwares, and they make tons of different types of clay because every potter has different needs for clay.
What does a box of mud cost, or a box of clay?
There's about 40 pounds in there, and it costs about $30, so by the time you get the shipping on it and stuff.
How many, like, coffee mugs can you get out of one of those boxes, you think? I've never been asked that.
A couple of dozen. 2-3 dozen.
That's fabulous. That's a good materials to output, but then there's all the work and 9 hours.
Well, it's labor intensive for sure, and then the electricity is expensive.
Do you have a potter's wheel?
Yeah, this is in here. It's sort of hidden right now, but...
Okay. I see.
Because I've been making these trays, right? But this is where all the basic stuff on the wheel happens.
Oh, that's cool.
Yep.
I'll have to come back again when you're actually doing some wet work, because that's always beautiful to watch, right?
Yeah, it's cool. That's why I put it in front of the window, so that people can peek in.
Peek in. Oh, right. So they can see your process, right?
Yeah.
Okay, well, I'm going to sign off. I'm going to wrap up my cup and eat the rest of my ice cream before it turns into soup.
Ice cream soup.
And, well, thank you so much for... do you have a card or something like that?
Yeah,
maybe.
I do. Yeah.
Thanks
for coming in.
Oh, you're welcome.
Okay.
Aspinall Pottery. All right. Okay, and on to the next thing. Well, it looks like it was a risk worth taking. My car is still here, still in one piece, and I got a coffee mug and an ice cream cone. All right, let's head to the beach. See the water. Okay, so when you come to the beach, need some sun protection. I came prepared for that. Got myself a Tilly hat right here. Tilly hat. And what you do, if you want to put this thing on the right way around, you hold it like this, and if you can read Tilly hat the right way up, you know you got it in the right direction. You just kind of go like this, and then you're an intrepid jungle explorer. All right, let's go looking around. So this is a really big beach. And I'm in the middle of it. It's just, I think we'd be under like about 30 feet of water right now if it were high tide. And I think way over there, those little teeny specks on the horizon might be my people. They might not be. Let's go find out. Well, I'm back in from the beach. I spent a nice time out there with my friends. But you don't shoot kids in videos, so I put the camera away for the whole time. But it was really fun. We found crabs and lots of crabs and hermit crabs. Those are the kind as well. But we found this really big one, and it's like I'd lift a rock and the kids would be like, oh, there's nothing under that one. Try again. So we'd lift the next one. Oh my God, there's a big crab this big. And you know, and Ariel was like, dude, at the end of the day, you can't bring him home. Please, no. The last time you brought a crab home, he died. You know, like, we're not killing any more, you know, sea life. So anyways, so that came to the end of that. That was a couple hours of a really nice sort of beach trip. And we're heading back into town. I'm gonna go home. All right. Well, here we are back home again. That was quite a cool day. We wound up with all kinds of cool prizes. Went to some neat shops, got some ice cream, got that neat coffee mug, and a few other bits of groceries and stuff, and I went to the beach. So that was neat. And that was another day in Nova Scotia. Well, anyway, thank you so much for joining me on this little adventure, and I hope you'll join me again for the next one. All right, take care, guys. Have a great day.